This weekend, Formula One action finally returns to our screens following a gap of more than 200 days. The 2020 season will kick off with a season opener at the Red Bull Ring in Spielberg, Austria. This will be the first time in Formula One's 70-year history that Austria will play host to the first round of the championship. The Alpine nation joins a club of just 10 other countries to have ever played host to the start of a Formula One season. There are some surprising tracks on the list of season openers, and we thought that would be interesting enough to drag out for an entire 8.5-minute episode. You're welcome. This is the first race of every F1 season. The first ever round of the Formula One World Championship took place on the 13th of May 1950 at Silverstone in the UK. When this first race took place, Silverstone looked vastly different to the huge racing complex that exists today. While many of the corner names have survived the test of time, the layout of the track is now completely different. Based on the site of a World War II era RAF base, this 1950s layout ran around the outside of the runways. The winner of this inaugural event was Italy's Giuseppe Farina, the man who would go on to win the championship that same year. Silverstone, and by extension the UK, would only ever host the season opening race in 1950, with the British Grand Prix moved to later in the season from 1951. Switzerland took on the role of season opener for the 1951 season. The Bremgarten public road circuit was the host track, a now defunct street circuit set near the city of Bern in Switzerland. It hosted the season opener in both 1951 and 1952, but only remained on the calendar until 1954. Ultimately, it was removed during the aftermath of the 1955 24 Hours of Le Mans disaster, which saw all motorsport banned in Switzerland, a ruling only overturned in 2007. While a Swiss Grand Prix did return to the calendar in the 1980s, this race was actually held in Dijon, France. The 1953 season saw the first running of the Argentine Grand Prix held at the Buenos Aires circuit. This is a track you'll see pop up plenty of times on this list, with the Argentine Grand Prix having hosted a total of 15 season openers, the second most of any nation. During its initial spell as the first race of the season, Buenos Aires hosted the opening race for 6 years, between 1953 and 1958. The circuit has several layouts, and many of these variants have been used during the track's tenure as a round of the Formula One Championship. Circuit number 2 was used during this first term on the calendar, a layout with a nice mixture of long flowing corners and tighter hairpins. Unfortunately, this version of the track does not feature the iconic corner names of Curve 1, Curve 8, and the Ascari Chicane. I'm not kidding, those are actual corner names at Buenos Aires. Anyways, fast forwarding to the 1959 season, and it's actually the Monaco Grand Prix that hosted the opening round. As surprising as it seems, Monaco actually opened the F1 season 5 times, in a period between 1959 and 1966. The Principality hosted the opener every other year in this period, as well as in 1964, before handing over the reins forever. Would you like to see Monaco host the season opener again? It seems like an alien concept in modern times, but let us know what you think in the comment section down below. After returning to Buenos Aires in 1960, the next Monaco off-season was 1962, and it was Zandvoort that picked up the role of season opener. Similarly to Silverstone, Zandvoort hosted the first race of the season just once, although it's hosted 30 Dutch Grand Prix in total, with the 31st running of the event cancelled this year. In 1962, Graham Hill won the race, the first win of the season that would see Hill win his first world championship. He would go on to become the only person to date to have completed the Motorsport Triple Crown, winning the Indy 500 in 1966 and the Le Mans 24 Hours in 1972. We're certainly looking forward to F1's return to the Netherlands next year. Until then, the F1 2020 game will have to do. 1965 saw the third and final running of the South African Grand Prix at the Prince George Circuit in East London. East London, South Africa, that is. You can thank colonialism for that confusing mess. Anyways, this was the first time South Africa played host to the season opener, although it certainly wasn't the last. After the Prince George Circuit was deemed too small for Formula One, the South African Grand Prix was moved to Kyalami. This larger circuit played host to the opening round of the season on many occasions, with its first spell being between 1967 and 1971. Over the years, there have been 7 different iterations of the track, with the biggest changes coming in for the 1988 season, which essentially saw a total redesign of the track. The 1970s were essentially dominated by the Buenos Aires circuit, hosting every opening race between 1972 and 1980, except for the 1976 season. Instead, that year, F1 began their race calendar with a stop at Interlagos. This one really took me off guard when I read it. In recent years, Interlagos has seen some incredible end-of-season battles, and yet it actually hosted the first race of the season on 3 different occasions. Defined by its long sweeping corners and elevation changes, Interlagos is both a fan and driver favourite. Throw in the chance for extreme weather and you practically guarantee entertaining racing. Personally, I very much believe Interlagos should host the season finale every year. To start the season with the track almost seems like a waste. Formula One is a truly global sport, but the one continent that's never really taken off is North America. For some reason, despite plenty of attempts, F1 has always struggled to gain an American audience. That being said, between 1976 and 1980, they actually hosted 2 Grand Prix in the same season, becoming the first country since Italy in the 1957 season to do so. Then, in 1981, the US Grand Prix West was the season opening race. After a return to Kyalami for the season opener in 1982, F1 returned to Brazil for the first race of the 1983 season. The race wasn't held at Interlagos, however. Instead, the Brazilian Grand Prix was hosted at Jacarepaguá. Apologies for my awful pronunciation. This track would host the opening race of the season between 1983 and 1989, and would later go on to be renamed the Autódromo Internacional Nelson Piquet, after Brazilian racing driver and three-time world champion Nelson Piquet. Following the move back to Interlagos for the Brazilian Grand Prix in 1990, the track has not seen any F1 action, instead playing host to kart, the predecessor to IndyCar, and smaller regional championships. The 1990 and 1991 F1 seasons saw the US Grand Prix host the season opener once again, this time at the Phoenix Street Circuit in Phoenix, Arizona. The most interesting thing about these races is probably the way Bernie Ecclestone handled the cancellation of the race for the 1992 season. You all know Bernie Ecclestone, and you know he was famous for having Bernie moments. Well, this is certainly one of them. After decent attendance to the races between 1989 and 1991, the city of Phoenix received word that the Supremo would like a race to be held at the circuit once again in 1992. After making plans, Ecclestone inexplicably cancelled the event in October of 1991 with absolutely no explanation as to why. The best part of all this is that F1 would not return to the US until the year 2000, with races held at Indianapolis. The 1992 and 1993 season saw F1 return to South Africa for the first time since the 1985 season. The round of the championship was cancelled during this period due to apartheid existing in the nation, that being the system of racial segregation. Following the abolition of apartheid in South Africa, F1 returned to the nation for the two seasons in 1992 and 1993. The country has not hosted a Grand Prix since then, with Kyalami now listed as an FIA Grade 2 circuit, blocking its ability to host a round of the championship. Interlagos returned as the season opener in 1994 and 1995 before handing over to Melbourne, Australia for the first time in 1996. As it turned out, Australia really liked hosting the first round of the championship, and they've gone on to host 22 out of the 25 season openers between 1996 and 2020. The Albert Park circuit is set on public roads, which are converted into a street circuit in the run-up to the Grand Prix each year. Gravel traps are put in place, grandstands are erected, and curbs are fitted to the corners to make the streets ready to host a race. The track now holds the record for hosting the most season openers, beating Argentina's previous record of 15. The track did not host the season opener in 2006, with the Australian Grand Prix moved to later in the year to avoid a clash with the 2006 Commonwealth Games. Bahrain took on the season opener in that year instead, and once again hosted the opening round of the 2010 season, with the race run on the extended endurance layout. This was due to be repeated in 2011, but civil unrest caused the postponement of the 2011 Bahrain Grand Prix. As such, Australia once again began the season. 2020, of course, saw the cancellation of the Australian Grand Prix in dramatic style, and as a result, Australia will now host the first race of the season this weekend. And that's it. That's every F1 season opener. I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, why not leave a like? And make sure to subscribe for more content like this in the future. Till next time, goodbye.